Hello, daydreamers, and welcome to what I hope is gonna be a new episode on The Last Alliance Total War playthrough that we've been doing with playing as Mordor. I have stopped playing this because I got a corrupted save. I couldn't pass turn 35. However, recently I saw a post by Sarah Temer, the main developer, at the Last Alliance Total War Discord, that the link will be in the video description. You can check in there if you are interested in this mod and also where to download it, etc. That she mentioned that actually there might be a solution to this bug that is, it has nothing to do with the mods, but with Shogun 2 itself. That sometimes happens that when you take out the last region of a faction, like I did in this case in here in Eosdun, and then the armies that are still in the region, in this case we have the Son and Heir, because I think I already took out the leader of the faction that now is recovering. In a few turns he would appear again. But what I did in the playthrough proper is I took Eosdun, and these guys became rebels of their own faction. And then when I took them out in turn 35, then that's what corrupts the save, actually. It seems that that's the problem. And then everything I would do after turn 35, it just the save file would get corrupted. And all the saves that I do afterwards, they just won't load again. And I did, actually, I did a ton of, I did try several things to fix it. And I played one weekend, I don't know, like 12 hours straight, and I pushed as far as I could, etc. And yeah, in the end, all the saves that I made during those 12 hours run, and the battles, etc., blah blah blah, I couldn't load it. So I have come back to turn 34. I have done a couple of saves and turns, etc., and I'm trying to get rid of these guys first before taking the last their capital, Eosdun. So I have just used my spy here to make sure that they don't run away, because they always run away. And I'm gonna see if this time... Yeah, okay, we have a fight. So, let me do a quick save in there. I'm gonna do this fight. I'm not gonna... I already published all that before. This video is more than anything to see if we can save this campaign and then we can continue it. So, I'm gonna do this off camera. And hopefully, if that works, I will take Eosdun off camera as well. And if I can pass turn and the campaign continues, then we have an episode. And if not, I will delete this footage and look into something else. Well, I'll be damned, guys. The fix that Sarah Temer posted on the Discord, it works. We just saved the Mordor campaign. I'm glad that I saw the post and I tried it. So it took me quite longer than I thought I to take out the rebel, well, not rebel, to take out the army that was around in the province, because they were just retreating, you know, they didn't have the strength, they were retreating, and the agent is not infallible, and they fails to sabotage them, so they cannot move. I had to keep pushing, and in the end I took them out around this area. It took quite a few tries, and by the time I took out the heir of the faction, the leader already spawned back at the Eosdun and recruiting some units. So I had to go back, siege the city, and I didn't have a very good odds. Don't tell me it's gonna crash. Well, I thought the game was gonna crash. Finally, they actually came out. I was bringing some extra units. I didn't know if they would arrive on time. And actually, they sail out, and I had to fight them. I didn't record it because I already did all this in the playthrough, and I just wanted to make sure that this was working. And as you can see, I took Eos Dune. This was their last city, so the faction, the message won't be there anymore. I think. Yeah, the when you come out of the game, is not there anymore. But I took out the faction, so they don't, they are not here, the earldom of blah 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 blah. And here we are. So you can see that turn 38, I was locked at turn 35. That was when I actually took out the army, I took out Eos Dune, and then I fought the army later, and that's what corrupted the save. But doing it the other way around, they took much longer, but I took out the army that was in the region, and then I took out the last settlement, and the save is working. So we saved the campaign with this. I will continue. I'm gonna leave it here. It's just gonna be a short video mentioning this. I'm gonna take note, not only for this mod, but for this, it seems that it happens with Shogun 2 in general. So in vanilla and any other mod that you play, this is something that can happen to you. So it's very good to know. And from now on, always take a look that any army in the last region, you have to take it out before you take the last region. Otherwise, the safe is gonna get corrupted, gonna get happening this over and over. But also for other Total War games, I think I'm just gonna make it as a rule to always keep that in mind, that can happen. And if you get a corrupted save, have a look at that, because maybe you can still save your campaign. So I'm gonna continue with this. The only thing is that I did play a ton before giving up, because I played one day like 12 hours, one weekend. And I saw a lot of stuff. These guys are very powerful. They how are they called? The Eringallen. So now I know a little bit what's gonna be happening in there. So I'm gonna focus on this side just to build up the castles and the garrisons as strong as possible. Not planning to push any further, but to hold these cities if I get attacked, and focus in this campaign in this area. So Pelargir is very difficult to take out, so what I'm gonna try to do, I'm building as strong as I can the army for Anatar, and I'm gonna try to take Lin Hir. I did take Kalen Bell in a parallel universe, and Ethelon. Actually, I did also take Myr Falas, and Ethelon declared war on me and landed in here. Who's gonna fight me? So I'm gonna try to take this first. Maybe Ethelon comes, or maybe they hold. See if we can take the Pelargir out first, and I'm gonna have to fight Ethelon eventually. But that's gonna be the focus of the expansion right now. In the south, eventually, I think our allies, the Haradrim Black Snake, is gonna take out these guys that declare war on me for some reason. So I won't be able. I won't need to focus on the south borders, but anyway, all the north side, I'm gonna just build up the castles and the garrisons to try to hold as good as possible. So I just finished with the field, so I need I'm gonna need a lot of food for this to build up the garrisons and castles. So this is 3 turns, and then there will be another 5 turns to get to the maximum. And but every time that you build up the castles and all that, you see from 4 you go to 6, so you need, and the garrisons also, where are they, here, they eat a lot of food. So I'm building that. I have 24 right now extra, predicted 34, but as soon as I start improving the castles and garrisons, all that food is gonna go down. So that's why I'm going that way. And then we will try to fight our way here in Pelargir. But anyway, because I was waiting, actually, I stopped playing this campaign waiting for a major new update, and maybe when I do, when that happens, what I will do is start maybe a new one with another faction that I already had in mind. But in the meantime, I'm gonna keep playing the Mordor campaign, just to let you know. And if you're having issues with a corrupted save, this could be a fix. So I'm very happy that this is working, and I'm gonna leave it in here for now, a short video. But then I will come back once we can start pushing in here. But anyway, thank you very much. I hope this helps to anyone that is having issues as well. And now I have to go back and check how to develop and buildings, etc. I forgot. It's been so long since I just played. But anyway, thank you very much for your time, guys. I hope this helps. And remember that Sauron, Anatar, is watching you, and he can see everything. Take care, guys. Happy New Year, and see you soon with more of Last Alliance Total War!